How's it going, everybody? Oathkeeper Sora here with my new LP of Kingdom Hearts 1. Now, I was going to do the final... Well, we're going to be doing this on Expert, but originally I was going to do the final mix version, but I'm just going to warn you now. I'm going to get lost on this game. There's no two ways about it. And, yeah, I decided that the English version would probably be better because... I don't think I'd have done very well on the Japanese version, let alone the English version where I'm going to get lost anyway. So yeah. Anyway, we're going to talk more on this subject after this awesome opening cutscene because it's cool and stuff, you know, because that's just how Square rolls. Anyway, I'll see you guys after this cutscene. Enjoy!
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
Alright, back into game. Hope you all enjoyed that cutscene. So cool. And the end is very reminiscent of the Kingdom Hearts 2 opening. Well, the Kingdom Hearts 2 opening is very reminiscent of this opening. In the sense that in Kingdom Hearts 2 it's Roxas that falls down to his... is it Stage of Awakening? No. Area of Awakening? Station of Awakening, that's it. Alright, use the left analog stick to move, tilt it slightly to walk, and harder to run. Okay, that was easy. So yeah, what I was saying about doing the final mix version is that there is one fight actually on the final mix that I really wanted to do, but I've pretty much forgotten what to do in each area of this game. Like, until today, I forgot that Alice in Wonderland was even on this game. Let's go for the sword. There's also magic and defense. Defense would probably have been a wise option, to be honest, for expert mode, but never mind. Yes. But yeah, I've completely forgotten what to do and where to go, really. So I would rather the game be in English for when I do get lost. Simple as that. What do we give up? Magic or defense? Well, I think we'll just keep with our defense to be normal. I think it basically just pluses one to your stats and then minuses one to whatever one you pick. You give up this power? Yes. You've chosen the power of the warrior. You've given up the power of the mystic. Is this the form you choose? Yes. Maybe not. Oh god. Platforms disappearing and... Oh, that's not all that's disappearing. Holy shit, we are falling down into the abyss. Down we go. Into the darkness. Oh, speaking of darkness, actually, and the abyss, I was doing a drawing yesterday that was gonna... Well, that I was gonna post up today, actually. It was of Aqua and Camtasia. Goddamn, froze on me. And it was quite a good picture. Maybe I'll put the final picture at the end of this video. But yeah, it was. I was pretty happy with it. Ooh, you've gained the power to fight. Yeah. Okay. Looks like we've got our one swing move. All right, you've got it. Damn right, I've got it. Use this power to protect yourself and others. I think that's what it said. If you run out of HP, you'll be taken to the continue screen. The blue gauge shows your magic points, MP. Magic is still a mystery to you. Trust me. After that thing's just popped up, anything is most certainly going to happen in this game. Magic, obviously going to exist. I mean, if these things can exist, so can magic. It's just a matter of time before we're introduced to it. You gain experience points. Oh, you gain XP by defeating enemies. With enough XP, you gain a level. Ta-da! Like with most RPGs. Furthermore, defeated enemies sometimes leave items behind. You can take these items by walking up to them. Sweet. Different items can do different things, like restore HP or MP. That's pretty much it, really. I don't think any other items... Oh, right. Yeah, there's accessories, I guess. I guess you could count them as items. Generally, you'll automatically target the nearest enemy near you, but you can lock onto a specific target by pressing R1. Lock on will appear in the upper left corner of the screen while you're locked onto a target. Locking onto a target limits the actions available to you, especially against other targets. Press R1 again to release a target lock. Sweet. Okay, so I guess we just gotta kick some out. Oh, that's a pain, actually. With these shadows, because they hide underground. Damn them! Get back here. Here we go. And he disappears. Unfortunately, I will be talking through a few cutscenes in this game. Not like constantly, but like I'll say like the odd one-liner every now and again throughout a cutscene. It's just because if I don't, then YouTube just makes it so I can't monetize my videos, which is gay, since I want some dosh. And that's about it, really, to be honest. But I'll try not to talk through important stuff, because you know how I roll. If I do talk, then it's generally just to either say something witty or just to... talk about something on the subject that they're talking about. I can open it. It's because we need a key. So you know what keys do? Keys unlock things. Okay. Random treasure chest. I swear, I can never... thinking about saying treasure chest has just made my tongue go blank. You can take these. We already saw that in the last part. Use them with the item commands. Okay. No doubt we'll be needing that later. You can lock onto objects as well as enemies. While locked on, press L2 to switch your focus between available targets. Okie dokie. Anyway, let's just crush the shit out of that barrel. This is actually my second time going through this. Not sure what happened. I think I pressed record too early. And it basically, my PS2 started having a panic attack. And wouldn't... I don't really know what happened, actually. All I know is my PS2 has a panic attack every time you go on component. Like, output it to component. Not sure why. But it never loads up, like, straight away. It always has some kind of... yeah. Weird attack thing and takes forever to load. And I think that I pressed record too early, so it didn't actually register that the component cable was in the PS2. Goddamn stupid PC. Anyway, the attack command has changed to talk. That sounded weird. Select talk to strike up a conversation with someone nearby. Hello. What's most important to you? Being number one! Yeah! Is being number one such a big deal? Yeah! Hey, it's Waka. Waka, Waka, Waka. Sorry, had to do it. What do you want out of life? To see rare sights, I guess. To see rare sights, huh? And there's Tidus. But is it Tidus or Tidus? Because, this was the first game that was voiced and they called it... No, it wasn't. What am I on about? They call him Tidus in this, but in Final Fantasy X, they call him Tidus. Is that what it is? I think Tidus sounds better. It sounds like Tide. Tide's cool, isn't it? Anyway, if you're wondering why I went for all the first options, it's because those questions right there basically determine how fast you'll level up throughout the game. If you pick the first ones like I just did, then... you level up early throughout the start of the game. I think it's up to level 50, I think. I'm not entirely sure. It might be... I just made that up at the top. Out. I can't talk. I seriously cannot talk. Mouth has gone blank. Anyway, if it says your day will start... No. I didn't even read that. I am stupid. Basically, if something starts at dawn... you level up fast at the start of the game. If it's midday, you level up at a steady rate throughout the entire game. And then if it's evening, I think, or night, I'm not entirely sure what it is, then it is you level up very slow throughout the start of the game, and then you level up more quicker at the end. That is what it is. Oh, I've got to come to this light here. I see. Press the start button to open the menu screen. In the main menu, you can do things like view your inventory and status, or status, however you pronounce it, or configure your game settings. However, you can't open the menu during battle. Well, in case I want to somehow change the menu or change inverted cameras. Hell no! Oh, looks like my friends are back here. Oh yeah, we got a full posse here. Bring it on! Boom! There's two of them gone. Oh, you want some too? Ow, I don't want some. Get out of my face. Nope, sorry. The only chance you guys have of beating me is if you decide to... Ow! You're gonna all have to jump me at once if you want to kill me. I won't hold you to that though, and please don't try it. Oh, we leveled up. Sweet. Oh. Is that it? That's all of them. Sweet. Ooh. Alright, here. This is known as a save point. This is a save point. Touch save points. Alright, yeah. I guess that makes sense. Touch save points to recover HP and MP. Open the save menu by selecting save, then press X to confirm. Be sure to save your progress before quitting the game. It's a good idea to save often. If anything goes wrong, you can then load your save data and resume from there. I guess that makes sense, right? But are we going to save there? No, I don't think we are. Oh, I really like those stained glass steps. I guess that's what you could call them. Man, this is such a I have such a nostalgic feeling right now. Oh, these damn Station of Awakening, giving me the old nostalgic feeling. Ooh, we've made it somewhere. The closer you get to the light, the greater your shadow becomes. I love how that part of the song is cued directly on that line. Oh shit. But don't be afraid. I don't think the game has seen what's coming after me. Don't be afraid. Oh, and don't forget. Whoa, that thing had half its chest missing. It looked like it was pretty heartless. Oh god. Yeah, that thing is... Oh god, it's even cut out in the shape of a heart. This thing is really heartless. Anyway, this thing here, I've forgotten its name. Is it called... I know it has a cool name, I know that much. I just can't remember the name right now. Right. If you actually get on its hand... Oh, bollocks. No. Okay, we're going to need to take some of these things... Okay, that works. There's the Twilight Thorn. Is it... Oh, it's called Darkseid. That's what it's called. Because they're based off... Well, their names are from horror movies, actually, if you didn't know that. Oh, God! Yeah, you get technique points in this game, which I was pretty sad, actually, because... Okay, let's try and line this up. And holy shit! Oh, crap. That didn't work. Yeah, you get technique points in this game. You basically get that for doing something cool. That's about it. If you block something, and then... Well, yeah, it's generally if you block something with an attack that it works. Right, if you actually come up here, though, and attack his head, you get 2 technique points. Like so. See? Ta-da! Oh, have we done that? Oh, no, I just leveled up. You guys can get out of the way. You can actually kind of farm here. I wouldn't really recommend it though, since you only get... Actually, I suppose you could. But whatever. It's up to you. If you want to stay here for ages, killing Heartless, because I'm pretty sure they're endless, then be my guest. I think 3 come out now. Yep! Boom. Wow, we just leveled up... We leveled up 3 times already in this video. Holy crap. The sword is just like, fuck you, Sora, I'm out of here. But don't be afraid. We are plunging into darkness right now. We're goners. You hold the mightiest weapon of all. So don't forget. You are the one who will open the door.
Give me a break, Kairi.
Sorry, you lazy bum.
Do you know what I just went through?
You snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yes, sure.
Say, Kairi, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you know this. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh?
What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
Oh man, this is so nostalgic! And so epic! Alright then, that's going to cover it for part 1. Hope you enjoyed it so far. Yeah, that's going to do it for now. And I'll see you guys, hopefully, on part 2. Thanks for watching, and peace.